quite a rebuilding process since the Sydney Olympics. But the question has remained, has this rebuilding been successful? Well, so far, so good. The red, white, and blue has been raised for every medal ceremony at these World Championships. The U.S. has been led by some refreshing new talent. Carly Patterson has emerged as a great all-arounder, winning the women's all-around silver medal. And Chellsie Memmel wasn't even expected to compete at these World Championships. She flew in to replace an injured teammate, and she helped America prove that the U.S. definitely is back. Welcome to Anaheim, California, and the Arrowhead Pond of Anaheim for the 2003 World Gymnastics Championships. Hello, everyone. I'm Peter Vidmar, and so far we've seen some amazing competition. The U.S. women winning their first ever team gold medal, and Carly Patterson winning the silver medal in the all-around, but there's more medals to come for many of the athletes here. Now it's the individual apparatus finals to see who is the best on each piece of equipment. Joining me in today's broadcast is a member of the 1996 gold medal winning team, the Magnificent Seven, Amanda Borden. And Amanda, we've seen some great stories come out of this women's competition so far.
We have seen outstanding performances, but one of the greatest stories has been Chellsie Memmel. She was not even a part of this world championship team. She won the Pan American Games, flew straight to the competition to be an alternate. But due to three injuries on the American team, she stepped up to the plate and helped lead them to gold. She has two more chances to win gold in the event finals, as well as a teammate, Hollie Vise, will be competing on the uneven bars.
And there's a lot more action on the floor, and helping us there will be your teammate from 96 on the men's side, John McCready. John?
Well, we're in for a treat tonight. I'll be on the floor all night bringing any up-to-date scores or developing stories. But more importantly, tonight we have a young versus old crowd. We got athletes as Hollie Vise, who's 15 years old, and then athletes like Oksana Chusovitina, who's 28 years old and has a great shot at winning the vault. Nothing but great stories coming out of here, Peter.
Thank you, John. And we're going to have an exciting first event now, the floor exercise. Probably, I think, the most exciting event in the gymnastics.
The crowd loves to see this event.
This is going to be great. The first up for Romania is Andreea Munteanu. She's a very exciting floor exercise performer. She had a preliminary score of a 9.412, sixth place qualifying coming into this event.
Peter, you're going to see a lot of action-packed floor routines. You see right there, tuck jump double, moving right into her first tumbling pass. Beautiful full twist and double back, slight hop on the landing there.
Now, how much of a deduction when they take a hop like that, is that?
That can be anywhere from a tenth to possibly two tenths, depending on how far they step back. Very nice landing on that double pike.
Now, the dance moves are just as important, really, as the tumbling moves, aren't they?
That's right. Beautiful flexibility on her gym series there. She gets ready for her third tumbling pass. You're going to see a lot of athletes performing more than three tumbling passes now to get the difficulty requirements. Whip right into a double full. The music slows down. She's great choreography. She's having some fun out there.
She does. Long history of great gymnasts in Romania.
Required turn.
Now, it seems like the pace has slowed down a little bit for her. Is she kind of catching her breath, getting ready for that last pass?
Well, Peter, I never had to do four tumbling passes, but I can only imagine that adding that extra tumbling pass, she needs to breathe, catching her breath right there. Ending with a 2.5.
Very nice.
Showing off that flexibility right there.
Andreea Munteanu of Romania. But it's a clean slate when they start the finals. So she wants to put in the best performance that she can because she starts off with the first place competitor at zero. Although she had the sixth place score, she's going to be coming in here now starting in a very good position. A hit routine is always nice in the finals. There's your round off back hands. Oh, it's that whip to the double full.
And her last tumbling pass. 2.5 twist.
And you can see in the background there was her coach, Bellu. He's a fixture in international gymnastics, created some great champions over the years. Well, this routine, I think, should put her in contention. Here's your score. always the tension. A 9.4, not a bad score. You know, the scores are lower than they have been in past decades as we watch gymnastics. These we need to be more prepared for. A 9.4, though, is not a bad score in floor finals. And next up from Spain, Spain's first world champion, Elena Gomez. Elena Gomez won the gold medal on floor exercise at the 2002 World Championships. That was the first gold medal ever for Spain. And she's a great all-around performer as well. Seventh all-around at the European Championships in 2002.
Using a little more dramatic music there. Nice and slow. Sounds like it's going to speed up for the tumbling right here. Twisting double back.
A bit of a step there. I would imagine that'd be a bit of a deduction.
Looks like she over-rotated just a little bit. Again, coming right back with the second tumbling pass. 2.5 punch, front full, great landing. She didn't even take a step.
That's fantastic. Very difficult.
Very nice. Double turn with the leg at 90 degrees. Very difficult.
Sometimes the crowd doesn't appreciate how difficult those turns are they?
Oh, the dance sometimes is more difficult. And being able to turn on a floor that has carpet and padding is very difficult because it catches your toes.
Yeah, that's probably good. I'm looking rug burn.
Third tumbling pass. Beautiful landing. She's not giving a tenth away.
Absolutely. This is a great performance so far.
Woohoo! She's a turner.
Catching her breath, getting ready. Big pass, here it goes.
Double pike. Very nice landing. She fought for every tenth of those landings.
I'll tell you, I think this is going to be a little higher score. I think a little higher score than Munteanu. Let's see what they have to say.
Looks like the crowd likes it.
Yeah, she seemed to be more in control of her landings, I think. I think that's really going to pay off. Well, she should be in contention for a medal. We've got a few more performers to go, however.
Take another look at her tumbling. She opened with a beautiful full twisting double back. Slightly over rotation, her feet were underneath her, had to take a step back. Here's the difficult turn. Her legs in 90 degrees, all the way completed double turn, wow, right into a double jump.
You know, it seems that her only deduction in landings really was that first pass. Everything else was just right on.
The dance was beautiful. She showed great flexibility.
Well, she has a title to defend. She is the defending, she's the world champion from 2002 on this event. She's shown what she's got before, and she's showing it again tonight. A 9.675, wow, that puts her in first place so far. Got a few more competitors, but that was a fantastic routine. And while we have not seen the Americans perform yet so far in this competition, we'll see a lot of them. They've had a great world championship, so we're going to talk about that when we come back. And welcome back to the Arrowhead Pond in Anaheim for the 2003 World Gymnastics Championships. We're right in the middle of the floor exercise finals for women. And first up now, or next up on the floor, will be Catalina Ponor of Romania. And Amanda, another great gymnast from this country. They continue to put out fantastic athletes year in and year out.
The thing that stands out about Romania is they have the difficulty, but they're so consistent. Opening with her dance series, triple turn right into Popa as she goes into her first tumbling pass. A full in pike, again, a slight pop in that landing.
Here's her next pass, Amanda. It seems to me that we always complain in men's gymnastics that the women have the luxury of dancing out of a missed landing, and we have to land it perfectly or else we get deducted. You ever hear that flack before?
Oh, we heard it many, many times. I think the judges know when you dance out of it and you're in control,
yeah,
and when you dance out of it out of control, and they know and they'll deduct when it's appropriate.
And so far we've seen some incredible control from all the athletes on floor exercise. Next tumbling pass.
Triple full, very nice. You can see she completed three twists, landing her feet perfectly straight. The
judges look for those kind of things. If you do not complete your twist, you do not complete a jump like that, where she was slightly short on the jump double, they don't get credit, and it does affect their start value, which often causes our scores to be a little bit lower than we saw in the past year.
And some of the preliminary scores were a little bit lower than we're used to. She had the first place qualifying score at a 9.537.
Last tumbling pass, double pike, beautiful landing.
Wow, just perfect.
This is what it takes to be in finals. It comes down to every single point.
Oh, she's got to be happy with everything. The crowd loves it. She did a great job. This could be enough to put her into first place. Take a look at one of her passes.
Her first tumbling pass, full in pike. You could see that her knees were slightly bent. And again, a small hop in the landing.
But she shows a lot of power, good amplitude. Look at that, 2.5 twist, punch front layout. And here's the finish.
Beautiful double pike. Watch this landing.
There's the period at the end of that sentence. It's right on there. Now the waiting game. This could be enough to put her in first. That was a great performance. Ah, 9.7 puts her in first place. Now she's guaranteed a spot on the victory platform, but will it be the top? And we're going to find out next with our final performer on the floor exercise. She was the third place qualifier, Daiane dos Santos of Brazil. This is a big moment for her country. They have really come on strong in the last few years. They've got great coaches there. She's got a great personality. Does she have the goods, though, for a gold medal performance? We're going to find out.
She's going to have to fight for every landing, not only on her tumbling, but also on her dance.
Very powerful number. Here we go.
Opening.
Oh, my
God.
Loves this routine. She's going to have them in the palm of her hand if she keeps tumbling like this. She was the third place qualifier. She had a 9.512, but she's really, really pulling out all the stops right now.
She's got very fun, energetic music. The crowd always loves that, loves the two personality. Getting ready for her third tumbling pass. Pike front. Double Arabian. Beautiful landing.
She knows how to do these Arabians. That's just amazing.
It's a very difficult pass because it's a front landing. It's blind. You cannot see the floor when you're landing, so you have to have very good air awareness.
Much, much harder to land.
Oh, the bounce. The jumps are beautiful. Great height.
And that's amazing. This is the end of the routine, but you still have that amazing power in your legs. Catching your breath. Here she goes. One final tumbling pass.
Needs to stick this landing. Beautiful
wow.
Double pike.
Oh, this is amazing. Will this be enough? Oh, she's excited. And
standing
look at
ovation.
The crowd, a standing ovation. There's her coach. This could be history for Brazil gymnastics. They've never had a world champion in any event in gymnastics. Could this be their moment? Oh, she's thrilled. She knows she put out her best performance.
There is no better feeling than hitting your team, running off, getting a huge hug from your coach, having the crowd stand up. What else can you ask for?
You got to earn hugs from your coach, don't you, sometimes?
That's right.
Oh, and look at the crowd. And now the waiting game. Now look at this power.
She has great height. Beautiful double Arabian pike. She cannot see the ground. Spots it. Slight step, but unbelievable.
I'll tell you, if they're going to reward her for one thing, it's got to be for the amplitude. She's clearly the highest tumbler in the competition tonight. As a teenager, she has a mouthful of braces.
Watch this. Pike front through to double Arabian again.
Oh, wow.
Unbelievable. I didn't think it was possible to do two double Arabians in a routine, one pike, and have great landings.
And that final double pike. Once again, a stuck landing, and you can see the crowd just loving this. Her coach is whistling. Come on, crowd. Now let's see what she gets. We're going to see a full mouthful of braces if it is. And what's the score? Oh my gosh, a 9.737. She wins the gold medal. This is history for Brazil gymnastics, and the crowd is showing how much they appreciate her performance. Just an amazing routine. Really love that performance. They just appreciate great gymnastics. And there's some officials from Brazil. She has made history for her country. And so Daiane dos Santos of Brazil becomes her country's first ever world champion, winning the gold on the floor. Silver medal went to Catalina Ponor of Romania, and the bronze went to Elena Gomez of Spain. And there's Daiane dos Santos making history for her country. She's certainly stolen some hearts tonight. Another girl who's stolen some hearts is Chellsie, Memmel of the USA. She has an amazing story leading up to this World Championships. And where that started was the women's team finals, where Chellsie wasn't even expected to be in the meet. She came out from the Pan American Games as a reserve athlete, but after many injuries, they put her in the team, and she had great performances like this vault in the women's team finals. And if there was a team to beat, it was Romania, with great athletes like Monica Rosu here on the vault. Romania is always a team to beat. But Chellsie Memmel pulled off another great routine on the uneven parallel bars, and more drama took place on this event when Hollie Vise realized she did not have her number on. They had to put a piece of paper on her back and write her number there. This took quite a while, and as a result, it kind of flustered her a little bit, and when she got to the actual routine on the bars, she made a mistake. And for a moment, it looked as if the U.S. hopes were dashed. But Romania had just an okay performance as a team on uneven bars, and USA was still in the hunt. On the beam, Hollie Vise came back with a spectacular routine, hitting her balance beam routine for some redemption, a good score, 9.512. And the U.S. is back in the hunt. And once again, Chellsie Memmel pulling off a dream performance at the World Championships. The highest score for the USA team on the balance beam. And the battle for that team gold medal came down for both teams to the last event, the floor exercise. Catalina Ponor had a great performance on the floor, but it was Carly Patterson of the U.S. sealing the victory for the USA's first ever world team gold medal. It's never been done before. So the USA wins by a healthy margin in the end over Romania, who wins the silver. Australia has come on very strong these last few years. They take the bronze. This shows just how far the US women have come since Sydney. A great showing, the first ever gold medal for the USA. And the fairy tale is not over for Chellsie Memmel. We'll see more of her a little later. Welcome back to the 2003 World Gymnastics Championships. I'm Peter Vidmar with Amanda Borden. And now we move to probably the most difficult event in women's gymnastics, the balance beam. And first up, from Romania, Catalina Ponor.
This is always an intense event. Beautiful Anodi. Turning right back, backhand spring layout, gorgeous one. She's so beautiful to watch. She has great flexibility. She finishes everything all the way to her fingers.
Wow.
Right there, beautiful.
Now I'm gonna remind the viewer by giving the most overused term in gymnastics broadcasting. Remember, the beam is only 4 inches wide. Just amazing.
She's very solid. It's very difficult to get up on this event with the entire crowd watching you and handle the pressure.
And Ponor had a 9.662 in preliminaries for the second highest score coming into here. Once again, as we said earlier, we start from a clean slate, so she's going from zero, and so the pressure's really on.
But she's getting ready for another twisting backhand spring, three quarters, down to the beam. It's a requirement to touch part of your trunk to the body, to the beam. Getting ready to dismount. Round off double pike.
Wow, that's great. What a great landing.
Beautiful.
That's going to score well. And there's a fan. Boy, Romania is just always strong. They always have someone in all the finals, it seems. They're always in the hunt for medals. Just a great tradition in that country.
She had beautiful tumbling. Backhand spring layout, step out. Perfectly straight leg, not a single wobble.
Here's a great view. Look at that. Looked like she was a little off, but she used her legs to kind of get the balance back. So no mistakes there. This should score very, very well. This puts the pressure on the other athletes, too. Beam is not an easy event to stay on.
We always call it the make-or-break event. It comes down to every tenth. You can see right here she fought for it.
Yeah, and you know, I'll tell you, that landing could be the gold medal right there. You never know. A 9.587. It's a very, very good score, but I don't know. I think there's more to come, so we will see. Well, next up on the balance beam, probably, I think, the girl to beat. Just an amazing performance in preliminaries. She had the highest preliminary score, a 9.712. This is Fan Yi of China. And I'll tell you, if anything, the beam, I think, must seem wider for her. She's only 4'9", and she's 72 pounds.
Beautiful beam worker. Very fluid.
Wow.
Beautiful punch front, right into a ring jump. The Chinese always have great flexibility. Every gymnast is required a flight series, which is tumbling, leap, such as that, or switch ring, gym series, which is the leap series.
And turns as well, I would assume. Oh, there you go. Boy, she has just got so much confidence. And it seems to me that her transitions are faster, going from skill to skill. She's very deliberate in her movements, and that must take just an immense amount of time to be able to be comfortable doing that.
You can tell the athletes that are expecting to be perfect. Mm-hmm. She's getting up there with no doubt. Every skill, her body's in the exact position she wants it. When you only have 4 inches, there's not much room for error.
Yeah, but no hesitation, though. That's the thing. Here she goes, setting up for that dismount.
And a double touch.
Wow.
Wow.
Another step landing. Look at that. I'll tell you, I think that was a little better. I don't know, but it seemed to me like she was in a little bit more control, had more difficulty. This could be enough to put her in first place. And maybe stay there. I would read that for you, but I'm sure it was something exciting for the fans. So. And there's your teammates. Wow, that was one of the performances in my book at the World Championship.
Take another look. Beautiful punch front.
Boy, you see how her feet just grip onto that beam.
Showing great flexibility. Always my favorite view. Tumbling, swings right down.
And here's that dismount.
Beautiful double touch,
yeah,
great form.
We said landings would matter, and look at that, another stuck landing. There's her competitor. Now, she's sitting in first place, but I don't know. I think she's going to get bumped out right now because that was quite a performance. She's waiting. Oh, my goodness, a 9.812. That's the highest score of the meet so far in any event. Wow. Certainly launches her up to first place, and she has set the standard. This is going to be very, very hard to beat. Wow. And yet now, here's one that was... It would have to be the crowd favorite. Here's Chellsie Memmel. We've heard about her before. We know about her story. To find her here, Amanda, in the finals after all she's been through is just an amazing thing.
Beautiful. Copa. She's a very calm competitor. She takes one skill at a time. That's always a good thing on the balance beam. Wow. Punch front half, backhand spring. Perfect. Beautiful front aerial.
You know, she's much taller, of course, than Fan Yi, but she uses her height to her advantage. I think she's got an elegance about her that really stands out.
Oh,
that's
goodness.
Too bad. You know, in a finals like this, there's nothing you can do to recover from that. She's out of the medal hunt right now, and that's just too bad. But she has really stepped up to the plate for the U.S. team after coming from the Pan American Games, coming straight here, knowing she has to put out for the team and then doing a terrific job in the team competition. She's got to be proud of what she's done for the U.S. Now, how do you feel, Amanda? You miss a routine. It's a big event. You know it's a finals. You know you can't win. And how do you treat the rest of the performance?
You know, we as athletes train for that moment, unfortunately, because we're not perfect every time. To get back up and finish a routine solid, here comes the dismount. That shows a great competitor. She made a great finish, solid landing. And the crowd still loves her.
Absolutely, absolutely. She's here in her home turf. Well, she knows that she's out of contention for a medal, but she's had a great World Gymnastics Championships performance.
Here's the front half, right into backhand spring. That was very solid and very difficult. Here it is, standing Arabian.
Oh.
Again, it's a blind landing if you're off at all, and you can see your feet.
You can almost, you can almost see toenail marks on the side of the beam. She was digging in so hard to do that. And there's
beautiful
your
double pike.
Well, it won't be enough to win or even put her on the podium. But she's got to be proud of what she's been able to do in these last few days at the World Championships. And an 8.837. So Fan Yi leads, but we've got more to come at the World Championships. We're back at the 2003 World Gymnastics Championships at the Pond in Anaheim. One more performer left to go on the balance beam. And this is Liudmila Ezhova of Russia. Now, she pulled off a very important routine for her team on beam at the World Championships back in 2002 to help them win the silver medal, and then she ended up winning the title on beam at the World Championships in that year. So she's a competitor in this event.
Very creative tumbling series. Anodi, front aerial, side summy.
You know, and here's another performer that, to me, looks very deliberate in her movements, like she's just done this routine a million times.
And I'm sure she has done it a million times. That's the only way to be consistent on beam, is to do it over and over and expect perfection. Her gym series a little bit off there on that tuck jump full. Right into another full twisting back handspring.
Wow. Look at that, right on.
Beautiful flexibility. Wow.
Oh.
A full twisting back handspring going sideways. Remember, you said 4 inches she did that in. That's unbelievable.
And she's a very athletic performer on beam. A lot of power in her routine.
Very solid jump. Of course, her required connection jump. Getting ready for her dismount.
Look at this. Round off.
Round
wow.
Up. 2.5.
That's not easy to land. Okay, you know, that was a great routine. I don't think that's going to be enough for the gold medal, but what do you think, Amanda?
She didn't have near the amplitude and the flexibility. Great tumbling. You can see she had a lot of creativity. You can see there in the mount. And here's that tuck jump full. You can see slightly off right there, and that could be the deduction that takes the gold medal away.
And, you know, most people don't realize that those skills, while not flipping skills, are as hard as some of the flipping skills, or harder.
And a difficult landing right there.
And we talk about landings, and that step could be enough to drop her down a notch. Well, she waits for her score. A 9.55. You can see by the look on her face, she's got the bronze medal, though. She knew she didn't win the gold, but that's a bronze medal for Liudmila Ezhova of Russia. And there's our gold medalist, Fan Yi of China, a 9.812. So far, really, the routine of the World Championships. Just a great performance. And the final standings, Fan Yi of China with the gold medal, Catalina Ponor with the silver, and Ezhova of Russia the bronze. Chellsie Memmel ends up with sixth place.
Fan Yi.
And there's the smile of a world champion, Fan Yi of China. We'll be back with more world championships after this. Welcome back. Now, one of the gymnasts that did not make it to these apparatus finals had a terrific all-around performance, and that's Carly Patterson of the United States.
Carly first on this scene this year, winning the American Cup, came to the World Championships. She's a solid competitor. She scored her highest score here on this event, the balance beam. She's powerful, and she's always in control. Despite Patterson's tremendous performance, Russia's Svetlana Kortina capped off her all-around performance with a beautiful floor routine, which helped her capture gold.
And now for the vault finals. And first up for the vault, from the People's Republic of Korea, Yun-Mi Kang.
She is a tiny gymnast. This event's difficult when you're tiny. There's not much weight to hit on the board, but she has an incredible vault. Watch this, Yurchenko, 2.5.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Look at that, and she is tiny. There's her teammate, the men's team.
Let's watch her run again. She gets, a little bit off to the side there, but 2.5 twists completed.
Wow.
It's a slight step to the side.
She had a 9.418 average in preliminaries for fifth place, so she's got to move up here if she wants a medal, but wow, that was a very solid vault.
You can see right here, crooked a little bit on the board.
Ooh, wow, she was on just the side of that board. She still pulled it off. That was amazing. Now, it is a deduction if she goes outside of the lines that you see on that mat, but she stayed inside.
Now, in vault finals, they have to perform two different vaults from different...
Different
families. Again, a round-off entry, but she did a half twist on and almost a pike front half off.
Yeah, usually you see kind of the weaker vaults in the second vault sometimes. A lot of these girls don't really train their second vaults as much because all that really matters to them is the team or the all-around. But they have to do two vaults in the finals.
Take another look. There's the round-off onto the board, but she half twists on. Actually, full twist.
Wow. That is tough.
Full twisting back handspring on. Layout off.
She almost didn't complete that full twist. I don't know if that's much of a deduction. But there is a 9.443. And folks, that is not a bad score. Scores tend to be lower on the vault. And now an athlete with a very heart-wrenching story. Oksana Chusovitina on the vault. One of the oldest gymnasts here. She has a son back in Germany right now, is being treated for leukemia.
Very powerful vaulter. Front entry.
Wow.
Handspring 1.5 twist.
That's just amazing. She's a 7-time medalist at the World Championship. She's a 3-time Olympian. She won the gold on floor exercise 12 years ago in 91.
Wow. Front handspring front with a 1.5 twist. A little bit of form breaks right there with her feet coming apart, but a very difficult vault.
She said that she wants to do well at these World Championships because if she could do well, maybe win a medal, that notoriety might help her raise the funds to treat her son who's suffering from leukemia in Germany. She's married to a Greco-Roman wrestler on their Olympic team. Bakodir Kurpanov is her husband's name.
Getting ready for her second vault. Front entry again. Sukahara, 1.5.
She barely touched that line. We'll see if they give her a deduction for that, but those are two very powerful vaults. Well, now she competes for Uzbekistan. Her son is being treated in Germany because someone heard of her story in Europe, and they flew her son to Germany to treat him for his cancer. She could win a medal, I'll tell you. This is very, very, very powerful vaults. We've got a few more vaults to go, though.
Beautiful form on that 1.5 twist.
28 years old, a long history in the sport. That's kind of ancient, isn't it, Amanda?
Oh, yes.
Oh, a 9.41, currently in first place. We got to see if this is going to hold, but she could be the world vault champion. But she's going to have to beat Elena Zamolodchikova. She's a great athlete. She's won vault and floor at the Sydney Olympics.
Performing a Yurchenko double full. Beautiful landing. She held it. Show it off.
Now, that vault has kind of, the Yurchenko vault in some areas has been devalued just a little bit over the years. It's a very difficult vault, but there are vaults that are more difficult than that.
You can see she... back handsprings on double full, beautiful form, straight off the horse.
Wow.
Just gorgeous.
Her father was in the military, and he was actually involved in the Chernobyl cleanup after that horrible disaster, and ended up passing away in 2000 before he had a chance to see her win her two gold medals in the Sydney Games. She has another long history in the sport. But she's only halfway done. Let's see what she pulls out for her second vault. Here she goes.
Duke, double full, very wow. Difficult, fighting for that landing. You could see the look on her face. She's done a good job.
Wow, that was very, very difficult vault to land, too. Elena Zamolodchikova.
Takes a lot of power right off the board. Getting two complete twists all the way around again. Straight off the back of the horse, right in the center. Very nice.
She's coached in Russia by Leonid Arkayev, one of the great coaches, a 9.443. And so Oksana Chusovitina is the world vault champion. What a very, very heartwarming story for her. The gold medal from Uzbekistan, Oksana Chusovitina. And the tie for the silver medal goes to Young Mi Khan and Elena Zamolodchikova of Russia. And coming up next, Hollie Vise and Chellsie Memmel will compete for gold on the uneven parallel bars. Peter Vidmar with Amanda Borden at the World Championships. That was Edison Field, home of the 2002 world champion Anaheim Angels. And there's the Arrowhead Pond. And now up for the uneven parallel bars finals, Elizabeth Tweddle of Great Britain. Amanda, I saw her training, actually, in California at my son's gymnastics club. The British team came, and boy, she was great in workouts, and she sure is great here.
Beautiful form. A lot of pirouetting. There's a shoot over to handstand. Very important that they hit their lines again. Cast handstand right there, a little bit short. Getting ready.
We call that a Markaloff on men's high bar. I don't know what they call it in women's, but I used to actually compete that skill. Oh, nice full position double back dismount. A perfect landing. She won the bronze medal on the uneven parallel bars at the European Championships. And that was the first ever medal for Britain in the European Championships. So she's really becoming a star in her country in gymnastics.
She opened up with a release move. Giant full into the ginger that we didn't see. There's the...
Oh, it's the Markaloff, I call it. Hecht half turn straddle, getting ready for a dismount. A back in, full out to a perfect landing. Here's another view of that.
You can see her knees are completely together. Great form.
Nicely done. I'll tell you what, though. You don't want to get her mad because her her brother, James, is a member of the British under-21 hockey team. Oh, and a 9.512. That's not a bad score. Not a bad score at all. Let's see if it holds. She was the seventh-place qualifier on bars coming into this competition. And once again, you start from a clean slate in the apparatus finals. And now up from Korea, Kwang Soon Pyon, competing for the People's Republic of Korea. Wow, look at those hand placements.
Beautiful. Kikejager, great height. Great extension. You can see the bars are so far apart, they don't even have to bend their body to fit through anymore.
Oh, amazing, and she's so tiny, too.
See a lot of creative transitions up to the high bar. Getting ready for the dismount. Double layout.
Oh, a little step.
Small step.
That was a great routine, but once again, in the finals, you can't afford to take hops like that. There's Elizabeth Tweddle, waiting to see if she's going to win a medal or not. It's just a waiting game for her now.
Take another look. She had beautiful pirouettes. You can see right here into her release move. Not a single form break in the routine.
Just terrific byline. She reminds me a lot of the Chinese girls on the uneven bars. A similar style in the way they work, similar skills included in their routines. And here's her dismount.
Nice double layout, great body position, slight leg separation.
And that's the problem right there, that step. Well, we told you what happened in team finals with Hollie Vise and her number. John McCready's gonna tell us that she's ready now.
Well, I'm down here, and the first thing I notice, and I'm happy about it, is Hollie Vise does have her number on. I talked to her a little bit after the number incident, and she said to me, well, you know, those things happen, but this is water under the bridge, and I'm ready for a medal in this event.
Let's see if she can pull it off after this. Back at the World Gymnastics Championships, I'm Peter Vidmar, along with Amanda Borden, and we have the uneven parallel bar finals to go, a few more routines. Here's some of the younger fans looking at their heroes. And one of those heroes is coming up right now, Hollie Vise on the uneven bars. Kind of made a name for herself at the Pacific Alliance competition in 2002, winning the all-around. Kind of a newcomer to the scene, but boy, if she made a splash.
She has beautiful skills on this event. Very nice lines, solid handstands, stalders.
Wow.
Right into a pike jagger. Very nice.
So she is right on right now. I see no mistakes so far.
Keeps the hand right back up to the high bar.
A little short in that handstand there before this dismount.
Here double front.
Wow, that's hard to land. Very hard to land. Look at that. That's going to be a great score. That could be enough to put her into first place in contention for the gold medal. And that's her father holding that 10 sign. I don't know if she's going to get a 10. Those are hard to come by nowadays, but he sure is happy.
Watch her release move. Pike Jagger, great height. Beautiful form.
Just a fantastic toe point, good body line. Oh, this is exciting. This could be another gold medal for the USA at these World Championships.
She performed a very difficult dismount, double front. We talked about it earlier, it's a blind landing. She cannot see the floor when she's coming to it. She has to know where her body is, open up, feel the ground, bend her knees, and fight. And that's exactly what she did.
Wow. Let's wait for her score now. A 9.612, and she's currently in first place. Boy, the USA has really made a mark at these World Championships, and we are not done. Because next up is Chellsie Memmel, Hollie's teammate. This is another great event for Chellsie. She won 5 medals at the Pan American Games. Wasn't even expected to be here, and look at her. She's going now for the gold on the uneven bars.
Watch this release move. Pin door, beautiful heights, right down to the low bar. Very dynamic bar worker. Stalder's a little bit short there. Back
she
up
covered
to the high
nicely
bar.
Though, she's doing well. Her final sequence of skills.
Watch this, has to hit it right on top. Very nice. Double front again.
Oh my gosh, from an eagle grip. Double front from an L grip. Very difficult, that much harder to land. Now she did take a hop. She's gonna take a deduction there.
Did a lot of difficulty in that routine. Very dynamic, very aggressive. It's gonna be really close. Take another look at her mouth. Right into her release move. Nice handstand. Pin door, great height.
Wow.
Sees the bar. Packs also down to the low bar.
That's one of the hardest release moves on the uneven bars.
Beautiful form. Watch this right here. She folds in. Ah, looks like it hurts. Double front, looks for the ground. Little bit of a rotation.
If anything, that landing could cost her something. Well, obviously, it's going to be a bit of a deduction, but still, let's see what she can get. Hollie's in first. Let's see where her teammate stands. So America is guaranteed a gold medal in the uneven bars. Is it Hollie Vise or is it Chellsie Memmel? If she gets a high enough score. And oh my gosh, it's a tie. A tie for first place. She scores a 9.612. And the United States is on the victory platform, first and first. And the crowd is going absolutely nuts. They are all on their feet here in Anaheim. Who would have expected this? And a tie for first place, Hollie Vise and Chellsie Memmel of the United States. First place with a 9.612. And in third place, Elizabeth Tweddle of Great Britain. Another great historic moment for British gymnastics. But this caps off just a tremendous, tremendous week for the United States, both for the men and for the women. Once again, Hollie Vise and Chellsie Memmel sharing the gold. Elizabeth Tweddle in third. John McCready's with our two world champions.
All right, I'm down here on the floor with the new co-world champions of the uneven bars, Hollie and Chellsie. Hollie, let's start with you. First thing's got to be going through your mind is my number on my back. But what else is going through your mind?
Yeah, that was the first thing I thought about today, making sure my number was on my back. Then I just tried to focus on doing my best and hitting my routine, and this was my goal to win. So, and that I get to share it with one of my teammates. It's awesome.
Go over to your teammate. Are your eyes as wide as they can be? Is this a fairy tale or what?
I think it's a real fairy tale because just winning the team gold and then a bar gold, and again to share it with Hollie is just awesome.
This is really the best story I can possibly imagine for you guys. Congratulations and good job. Peter?
Thank you, John, and what a way to finish 9 days of great competition. As we look forward to the 2004 Olympic Games in Athens, the U.S. has proven that they are definitely a powerhouse to contend with. And so, for Amanda Borden and John McCready, I'm Peter Vidmar saying so long from Anaheim, California. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For more, log on to ESPN.com. We'll be right back.